2-1-13. My name's Ed Cowlish. I'll join in commentary with Josh Sampson. And Josh, a lacklustre start there by the Thunder, but the Giants, very impressive.
Yes, they were. Welcome back, everyone, for Tats Thunder Vision this evening. And yeah, the Thunder not moving it with their usual efficiency. I mentioned efficiency and cleanliness. Those were a couple of the words that came up during the call in that first quarter, and really messing around with the footy. And the Giants, to the credit, they got a lot of leg speed and a lot of young, youthful, fresh legs in their lineup, and they really use it to advantage. And hence why we see it's only 9 points in it, and really at this stage, it's anybody's game.
Interesting to see Wesley Black just getting a little chat to there, just getting the positioning right, yep. The speed and everything like that. And hey, look, he's a likely type. He's a good size as well. And they started him in the midfield as soon as he came on. So they must see a little bit of talent in him. And of course, if you're wearing the ochre and the red and the black and everything like that of the NT Thunder, you've got a bit of talent behind you. As well, Phillips jumps early and misses it all completely. Tyrrell taps it down, going in hard. His Vassal gets it out, trying to find Matty Argus. He's under pressure at the moment. Maybe a touch in the back there by Kintari. Play on there by Durkay. Kicks it long in the Hassan area. Rioli under pressure. This is Ben. Just tapped on the back for his work there from Asani. Sees it over the boundary line. Deep in the forward pocket for the Giants. And, well, that's another clearance. And they're doing very, very well in that battle at the moment. It's amazing when you take out a key stoppage player like Cameron Islett, how it just ruffles a few feathers in the Thunder shirts at the moment. So good work there by Tyrrell. Tap it forward to Vassal, running out of space off the boot of a Giant. But it's seen over the boundary line yet again. And we'll restart the action. 3-4-22 to 2-1-13. Only been going just a couple of minutes in this one. So as we get this reset. So 15 metres around from the goal on the Morris Rioli grandstand side. Tap down again. Two ruckmen going up there that time there for GWS. Redfern trying to get it out. Durkay tries to shake one. Great tackle there by Willie Cossack. Play on, says the umpire, and away goes the Jet and Heenan. He takes a couple of bounces inside the middle of the ground. Geez, had to be good with it. One mitten at it there that time there by Ewing. Jed Anderson got a bit of space to play with. Easy as you like. Willie Farrell loops on in, goes bang, rams it in to the sign and puts an exclamation mark on that piece of play for the NT Thunder. That's the fourth goal for the game for them, and they move along to 4-4-28 to 2-1-13.
That's more of the ball movement that we like and that we've become to know with the NT Thunder. Again, the Giants is kicking a goal, a very similar one where it was just all counter-attack. Everybody was forward of the ball there. Willie Farrell was forward of the ball. Argus was forward of the ball. Anderson, the beautiful releasing kick to find him over the top in space. So some very, very poor checking indeed by the Giants. And the Thunder now, 15 points is the margin. As the ball comes back in to the middle. Been a pretty good battle so far, I reckon, between Andrew Phillips and Kenny Tyrrell in the ruck. Sort of going in a bit alone again tonight. It's always a tough ask up here with the conditions and with the experience of Kenny Tyrrell. So the ball is bounced. The rucks go at it. Phillips and Tyrrell. Nil all draw, really, in the end. Jeez, Rosier throwing himself in over the ball. Into there was Clifton, and the ball is a bit of a stacks on. And is the umpire picked out a free kick here? He has. Oh, Kenny Tyrrell, it's the same sort of thing that's happening again. The hanging on and the undisciplined acts. And
he's got to be careful with that. He's got some carryover points next to his name as well. About 69 of them.
Yep, something like that. As Ugel drives them inside 50. G's 4-on-1 situation again. Argus, the good shepherd there. Oh, Benny Rioli, a rover runs what he would have gobbled up normally. In the end, a good tackle to save it, and the ball goes out of bounds right next to the left-hand point post in the Giants' forward 50.
Isn't it amazing when clubs like UWS and the Gold Coast, when they get some top-end, top-up players fighting fire with fire, with these small forwards, the electrifying players such as Durkay and the likes. It's great to watch.
It certainly is, and the ball now coming down, throwing himself in there hard over the ball was Dignan. Geez, cop one in the back from Aylett, and now the Thunder are away again. Heenan's having a bit of an impact. That's a beautiful kick. Oh, Anderson almost pulls down the mark. He's caught it there by Phillips. Gets around one, gets around two, too easy, and now they're away here. Done. He got Tavis Perry over the top. He goes to Ewing instead at half forward, and he's calling for it again. He's Willie Farrah being flanked there by Gold. He's going to get the hurry on here.
Lovely.
Smart kick in the end, and he finds Chris Dunn. All the goodness of hazelnuts and full cream milk, but that's a story for another time in Chris Dunn. And he's going to go for goal number 34 this season, a very handy contribution.
Big fan of his spreads, Chris Dunn. Loves it indeed, and that's one of his pet... Well, a lot of people say pet peeves, but this is a pet love. And massive fan of Nutella. Real, real big fan.
So done now from about 35 metres out, pretty much straight in front. Kick on its way. Goal umpire doesn't move. And the Thunder are up and about in this second quarter. Almost 4.5 gone. It's the Thunder 5-4, 34. They lead the Giants 2-1, 13. In fact, yes, it is. 21 points is the margin.
Yeah, look, they've snapped out of their slumber, haven't they? Two quick goals and really starting to put their focus in on it. And interesting to watch the two dinosaurs go at it at the moment. Yeah. The two ruckmen, they're snapping at each other's heels at the moment. Kenny's just obviously got under the skin of young Andrew Phillips, and he's happy to take it up to him as well. He won't be pushed around, and it's an enticing battle in the middle of the ground at the moment. Clearances is where it needs to be at, so Tyrrell goes hard at it, gets the ball, gets a clearance himself. All tried to pick it up that time. There was Wasley Black. Off the hands there was Smith. Oh, geez, play on, says the umpire, and he does so. Oh, under pressure there is Clifton. Vassell there goes hard for it. Dunn's there as well, got the outside of the boot there in Wiley. And here comes the likes of Ash Duncan. Oh, nice little shake and bake. Pops it up in the area of Dunn. He has to work hard for it and cleaned up in the meantime. Doesn't get the 50-metre penalty. But Dunn will look to play on quickly. He does so.
50 metres.
And 50-metre penalty going away of Chris Dunn. And he'll kick from point blank. So Chris Dunn to take the kick. Obviously the man going over the mark at the time. Trying to do some fancy defensive work there was UWS. And this is three goals on the trot here for the NT Thunder. And Chris Dunn, two in a row.
So a great contribution by Chris Dunn. It's been pretty much the story of his season, hasn't it? And the story of the Thunder forward line. You've got Darren Ewing with 50, Chris Dunn with 35 on the season now. Willie Farris chipped in with 22, getting a very, very good even spread. Talking about sharing the love and sharing the opportunities as we did. As the ball now coming back into the middle, and all of a sudden, it's 27 points is the margin. 6-4 plays 2-1. And it looks like Jaden Pryor, the big Alice Springs, the big fella, he's coming back into the ruck. And again, poor old Andrew Phillips, he's come up duck eggs, hasn't he? He is getting worked over big time indeed. Pryor wins the tap down. Anderson back in the middle. A little bit of almost a bit of friendly fire there from Pryor. Coming away with it, looking for Duncan, but overcooks the kick in the end. Geez, almost overcooking it as well was Nandu. Coming in over the top is Argus. Gets the handball out. Beautifully done. Anderson pumps the Thunder back inside 50. Oh, the volleyball slap from Farrah there. Almost overruns it. Well played in there also was Clifton, and they're looking to work it away. Oh, the athletic mark there from Jed Anderson. He might just yet make it to the Olympics.
Six possessions in the space of 30 seconds there by Anderson. He's everywhere at the moment. Gives it off to the Alising product in Pryor. He spots up Verncombe. Easily mistaken there for Farrow, but it was Verncombe that time. Over there to Ben Rioli, wearing the helmet, thinking safety first there to all the Thunder juniors out there or any young footballer. Smart thinking. Off there to the Sheriff and Jack Lawler. Spent what he had, got paid the mark in the meantime. So the Thunder, not one player in the forward half of UWS Giants. Amazing statistic this one. They're all just mucking around with each other as he goes onto the outer side. So just slowly but surely here, the NT Thunder just trying to set something up and create some space in there as well. Heading in the direction there of Anderson, seen over the boundary line, and it will be thrown in. So plenty of players around this spillage, plenty of orange there as well. Love the highlighter orange. It looks pretty easy there for the commentators to pick up some players. As the ball's thrown in, Pryor and Phillips doing the ruck work. Tapped on down that time. Fresh air kick there by Anderson, just building on the possessions at the moment. And they get some touch out of this one. So 60 metres out from goal here, the NT Thunder. Likely prospect of getting another one. They've kicked the first three of this quarter. And really, really looking the goods early on in the piece to blow this one out of the water. As the ball is thrown down there by Pryor, tapped away. And heading towards the boundary line again. Clifton under pressure there by Anderson. Tackled. And no free kick taken and will be thrown in yet again. So it is the Thunder doing it quite comfortably. 6-4-40 to 2-1-13.
8.5 gone here at TIO Stadium. Beautiful high looping throw in there. One down there was the tap by Pryor. Bit of an up and under kick in the end, and the Sheriff, Jackie Lawler, having a very nice second term here, looking to pump the Thunder back inside 50. The good strong lead and mark from Willie Farrah. Inspector Gadget style with the big long reach. And he'll have a shot for goal from about 40 metres out straight in front. And they're starting to blow it open here, the Thunder.
He is. If he kicks this one swiftly, he's going to have three next to his name already. And the big fella, number two, Darren Ewing, hasn't even really got into action.
So Farrah kick on the way. Wobbles. It's there. It's done enough, though. And in the blink of an eye, the Thunder are out to a five-goal lead. 7-4-46, they lead the UWS Giants. 2-1-13, 9 1/4 going here at TIO Stadium. And Willie Farrah having a very big impact tonight.
Oh, look, it's fantastic to watch the number 27 in action. Whether he's playing down back in the ruck or down forward, and AFL clubs have got to be looking at the prospect of this young star from Kununurra. He is he's exquisite to watch, and he listens to the coach. He's exciting to fans, and it's what the Thunder's really all about, isn't it? And UWS, they've really got to work themselves back into this game. It all starts here at the clearances. So Phillips taking on Pryor, trying to tap it down. Good work there by Darley. He's in the thick of it. Here come the likes of the Giants, this time through Wharton. A high up and under kick, but to no avail. And a fine mark taken there by the Sheriff in Lawler. So he comes along the Maurice Rioli grandstand wing, looking for Lachlan Argus. Great lead and mark that time. Tried to hand pass off there to Wasley Black. Instead, he goes inboard. And they're just starting to wax lyrical at the moment here, the NT Thunder. Jack Lawler, fine mark taken there by Mr. Nutella himself and Chris Dunn. Mr. Spreadable, as they like to call him. He's everywhere on the ground. To the Terrier and Rosier. He pops it up. A two-on-one situation. There goes the likes of Farrah. Snapped up there by Ewing. He gives it off unselfishly. Off to Rosier. He's in a bit of bother. He shakes and fakes. Rattles and rolls. In a bit of problems here. Lovely work there by Williams Jr. Easy as you like. Hey, look, if there's no one to guard down back, let's wander forward and see if we can pop through a goal. The number 18 does just that. Great link up there by Rosier and the big gun in Tavis Perry. And just quick sleight of hands, and that was an easy as you like goal. And the Thunder, all of a sudden, really starting to scoot away with this one.
Yeah, they certainly are. Great calling there of the contest. They were in and out, and they're starting to flex a bit of muscle here, the Thunder. Great finish, though, in the end by Damien Williams Jr. Just shook off his opponent and dished out the don't argue, as though he just does it for a bit of a hobby. And as you mentioned, it's blowing open a bit now. The margin all of a sudden out to 39 points.
It's amazing stuff at the moment, isn't it, Josh? And look, it's hard to see where UWS can get into it right now.
So the ball back in the middle. Downey and also Pryor go at it. Geez, Pryor throwing himself in there. Duncan picks it up nicely, goes for a searching handball and finds Rioli. Rioli looking to load it up onto the outer side. Coming back in there is the weapon. Can't quite find it. It was Brad Vassell. Anderson, though, throws himself on the ball. Beautifully done. Scooting away with it, though, is Matty Argus. He drives it up to the hot spot. Jumping from about six deep there is the weapon again. Timmy Golds now, though, brings it out. Anderson throws it on the boot. Oh, it's a scrubber, though, and it's going out to bounds on the full. Some good contested work there by Thunder, by the Giants, I should say. And the Giants will be looking to bring it back in and get it out of Thunder's 50. It's been parked in there so far.
Willie Farrah just everywhere at the moment, just jumping at anything that goes his way, which is what you want the forward to be doing. The check side there by Jed probably tried a little bit too much.
Yes, he did, as Darley now brings it out. So, again, they've put the press on here, the Thunder. All the numbers pretty much slotting themselves in nicely, is getting the hurry on now, driving it forward up onto the high looping kick in front of Downey. It looks like knocked away there was Kenny Cheryl. Jeez, he's throwing himself around a bit of don't argue. He's at his cantankerous best again this evening, and the ball goes out for a throw in front of another one of Thunder's great sponsors, Yiparunya Shopping Centre. So, geez, a lot of numbers at this contest as well. As looks like Downey and also Tyrrell are going at it. Bit of jostling, bit of fencing work happening there. Tyrrell wins it down, throwing himself in there was Rosier. No free kick, the umpire says no. Trying to scoot away with it there. Vassal's in tow, coming away with it all. The quick handball, not good enough from Aylett. Throwing it on the boot is Duncan up towards. Oh, good mark in the
great
end.
Mark.
Gee, that was a great mark. Going back with the flight, and he finds Jack Homsch, the South Australian. Switches the play now. Oh, geez, Tomlinson should have gobbled that up and ended up bobbling hobbling over, and he's affected a throw-in. It was an unforced error, my goodness me. And it's gone out 40 metres out, Thunder's attacking 50.
Brilliant effort there by Holmsch there to, on the last line of defence, put his body on the line. Geez, you'd think he was a South Australian with the way that he went about that. Am I right, Josh?
We're very proud of the work we do, and we know it. The tap one down there by Tomlinson.
Oh,
coming through, though, was Duncan. He gets it on to Argus, who's put it out on the full. My goodness. Absolutely yanked it off the boot. And, geez, again, after a very, very good start here by Thunder, they're starting to throw away a few opportunities.
So it looks like Holmes to bring it back in as he goes onto the outer side, just trying to find a lead-up target, and he does so. Still no one in the forward half here for UWS, which will be interesting once the ball gets anywhere near that area. Fine effort there by the likes of Aylett on the outer side, trying to find some targets. Geez, going to the fat side of the ground, and we can see why, because Clifton's come back on. But he's just being marked there by Rosier, so all this good work of coming back down the back line. They're just chipping their way forward. Oh, 50-metre penalty has been given away. A bit of mouth work being done there by the NT Thunder lads, so this is unfortunate. And now, finally, we've got some chickens in the hen house down there for the Giants as they go onto the outer side. The kick there by Daly, trying to set something up at the moment, and a fine mark taken there that time by the likes of Wiley. So Wiley on the outer side. Goes long and high and looking for some sort of target. The big ruckman will do. It falls to hands. Handbuff to Tyrrell. Trying to link up with Rioli. He does so. The sheriff in Lawler. Just kicking for space. And Lachlan Argus. Great. And he finds both of them. So Lachlan Argus on the half-back flank. Chips it across. Finds Ash Duncan linking up with the sheriff. Jack Lawler trying to find someone in attendance. Oh, look for Willie.
Oh.
Willie jumped a little bit early, as he always does. Trying to traipse it down this time. He's in attendance there with Bunteen, and away go the Giants. Oh, a little bit of pace on this one. It's Basil Barra onto the outer side. Finds Clifton slowly but surely now. He paces himself. Gets onto the scoreboard. Beautiful looking thing it is. Which reads 8-4-52 to 2-1-13. So the Giants just looking for some sort of options. It could come back from whence it came. It pops up. So Clifton now just looking for any sort of an option, and he finds one this time, and a fine mark taken there by Wiley. So Wiley looking down long, Hassan being guarded. He went there in the end. He hit the deck just when he wanted to, and the two number threes collide in Argus and Hassan, and it's seen over the boundary line. So double A batteries, eh? And they've just got energizer legs, those two. Pumping pistons. So the ball to be thrown in deep within the GWS forward line. Plenty of players around this scrimmage. Darren Ewing is still in the forward line there for the NT Thunder. Just seeing if a trend is starting to develop. Wherever the ball goes, the players go. Tyrrell gets it out. Nicely sharked there by the Giants. And a great-looking goal as well. Great work indeed there by Paul Green. In the right spot at the right time. The smallest man on the field. He's found a little bit of it. And got a goal out of it. So that's their third for the day. But, geez, they're trying to claw their way back into this one, you would think.
Yes, they are, but look, a good steadying goal for them there. Geez, they badly needed it because, as we've mentioned quite a few times in the call, it's been parked in Thunder's forward 50. I tell you, there's a young fella here who works on our production crew. Those who are familiar with NTFL footy, with Joshy Heath from
yes,
St. Mary's.
Yes.
Paul Green is very, very similarly built, and a very nice finish there
yes.
from the young fella.
He is, actually. I'm just having a look at the boys on the cameras at the moment. He's just nodding at that. He does look a little bit like the number 49 for UWS as Tyrrell taps it down. Nice kick out, heading in the likelihood of Farrah directions. Tapped away. UWS trying to get it forward, but it's the Terrier in Matty Rosier. Oh, geez, it's sublime footy by the Thunder. Right spot, right time, doesn't shave the post. It's gone through the middle. He's happy about it, the Alice Springs boy. And number 15 gets his first goal of the night. Matty Rosier, well done.
No waiting around there for Thunder. Geez, they just counter-attacked beautifully. One now there in the rut by Big Kenny Terrell. And, geez, this is what Thunder have really been building a reputation for over the course of the season, that ability to really respond quickly. They don't like conceding goals here at the home turf here at TIO. But great finish there from Matty Rosier. Continues some very, very consistent work.
No, does the job at the right time, doesn't he, Matty Rosier? And we've been going roughly 18 minutes so far, so there's still plenty of time in this quarter. Oh, might want to be recalled. No, Pryor gets the tap on that one. Paddy Heening's around this one, so's Basil Barrett. Bauer. He's in the middle now for the UWS Giants. Pryor just really toe-poking it forward, but it's to no avail, really. They're going laterally, the Giants. Here they go again. Redfern tried to get a handball out. A quick kick away. The smallest man on the field and the last goal kicker for the Giants in Paul Green. Just goes over the top of his head. Just, well, he's a bantamweight fighting in a heavyweight battle, you could say, as it heads into the area of the weapon. Joshy Sampson's boy. And, well, Nathan Brown just got held up there as lights go out here in the commentary box, but we'll play on nonetheless. They're still on out there on the ground. The weapon kicks it on quickly. Nice mark there by Farrow. Has to be paid. No, Williams Jr. goes over the top of it. Oh, watch the Giants line up for this one. The weapon on hands and knees, but it comes the way of Wilson. As we look in the dark, he pops it high up in the area. Green, he's the only man under it. Oh. But out of nowhere came Verncombe. He hand passes while he was falling down onto the ground. Willie Cossack got some time to spend, and well, he could be in a bit of bother as the UWS track him down, kicks it over the top of Lachlan Argus. Here comes the Jet in Heenan. Patrick Heenan, the Tiwi Bomber, a premiership player right there, looking for another one for the Thunder, and laces out. And the NT Thunder, well, just going through the motions at the moment and doing it ever so aptly at the moment as Jed Anderson is lined up, what, 25 metres out, slightest of angle?
Seems to be working himself in between sort of a floating midfielder sort of forward line role as the mood lighting just takes effect very nicely here in the commentary box.
Might have to get the lava lamps out in a minute.
We might.
As Jed Anderson just strolls on in and, just makes it tough for himself as he just pulls the kick and is through for a behind.
So Thunder moving along to 9-5-59. They lead the Giants 3-1-19. 40 points is the margin. Just about to tick into red time here, almost 20 minutes gone. So a bit of a huddle forming. Geez, bring back the old days of the Frio Dockers. And going up the line, good kick in the end, finds Jack Homsch, who's been very impressive so far tonight for the Giants. Went high in the draft last year, along the likes with Bunteen and Stephen Cornelio. Gets the hurry on now for the umpire. Brings it up grandstand side. The big fella in down. Coming over the top was the sheriff. Oh. Couldn't take the mark in the end. Slapped down beautifully there was Matty Argus. Some great pressure in and around the ball on Mark Wiley. In fact, no, he's given away a free kick. Interesting. I thought Wiley had a little bit of it and probably could have been pinged for holding the ball, but he doesn't. Oh, it's a terrible kick. Oh, geez, coming over the top was Farrah. The weapon handballs it inside, looking for Lockie Argus to Matty Argus, the brotherly love, linking up again, and he's popped it through for another goal. Gee, that was a dreadful kick coming out of the back line for the Giants, and the Thunder move along to 10-5-65 UWS, 3-1-19, 46 points the margin, and Edo, what is the golden rule of footy in your back line?
Well, don't kick it to the sheriff when he looks like an incy-wincy spider trying to climb over a map. That's what I think. I mean, that was amazing, wasn't it? I'm still in awe of that. But look, the brother's working well, isn't it? Lachlan Argus giving back to Matthew as Matthew gave one to Lachlan last week. So, geez, it's just brotherly love out there at the moment. And they're in control, the Thunder. It is 10-5-65 to 3-1-19. And it's just full control. And we knew they were going to wake from their slumber. Yep. We just didn't know when. As the ball goes up, tapped down there by Phillips. Oh, here comes a clearance for them. Just got out of the way there of Aylett. Great tackle there that time there by Verncombe. But the umpire saw it as, well, a little bit too high. Just slipped over the neck. So the Giants looking to set some sort of example up. Aylett. Famous name in AFL football, especially for all those North Melbourne fans.
Another turnover.
But not a good kick as it goes along the lines of Pryor. Off to Smith, onto the outer side. Jen Anderson's got a paddock to play with. You can't leave him all by himself. He might take one bounce. Oh. He might fancy himself from here. He's fumbled it a little bit. He shakes and bakes, sidesteps, does the hokey pokey, pops it up, and Darren Ewing can't get up there as high as what he would have wanted. And UWS look to clear onto the outer side, and it's going to head in the direction of Tomlinson.
Whoa.
Oh! Going just a smidgen early there was a sun. Just a smidge. And away go the Thunder. They play on quickly, but the umpire calls it back. So the youngster.
Gee, nobody on the mark there.
In Wosley Black. Oh, a wobbly finger-breaking punt. Heads up forward to Mr. Spreadable. So Mr. Spreadable in Chris Dunn, the number 24. He's been a great pickup for the Thunder this year. He's really filled holes, whether it's down back or up forward. Goal kicker, kick four on his debut. All the way back against Morningside. And away goes Chris Dunn. Roughly 45 metres out. Very tight angle. Good for a right footer. He
curls it back. Curls it back with aplomb. Brilliant stuff there by Mr. Spreadable himself. And Chrissy Dunn has got three on the board for him tonight. And again, being prolific, just be nice to get the number two into action, I think.
It would. We've hardly seen Darren Ewing, the big fella, so far, have we? He's been largely held pretty well. But Chris Dunn, and as he does along with the likes of Willie Farrah, stepping up again and contributing very, very solidly across the board. Yeah, that was a great kick. They're very, very deep pockets here at TIO, if you're not familiar with the surface. And not a lot of daylight there, so a good finish in the end.
Not a lot of daylight in here either at the moment, with the lights out here in our broadcast position in the Morris Rioli Grandstand.
So the Rucks go at it again. It's Phillips up against Tyrrell, one down by the ladder. Vassell throws it on the bit up towards half forward. Nice kick, and he finds Mr. Spreadable again, springing it out wide, and he finds Tyrrell, does Chris Dunn. Tyrrell pretty much bang on 50.
Well, he'll fancy himself here, Big Ken.
He will fancy himself. He's got a pretty good, very, very prodigious kick on him. I think he is going to fancy his chances. Oh, free kick's been given away.
Not downfield. Is it going downfield?
It's downfield, and we should talk about getting Darren Ewing into the game more often, because he's won himself a free kick for a little bit of hanging on, I think it was. No, so again,
Ken's going to be shattered. Ken Tyrrell is going to be shattered by that. Look, he is a very unselfish man, a team player, as Ewing slots through his first for the night. But KT would not be too happy about that. And, Wolf Ewing, he's got away with... go away with one, and probably one for his confidence as well, as we generally find when Darren Ewing gets a quick goal, he ends up with six or seven at the end of the night.
Yeah, he does. When he gets on a bit of a run, he is up and about, and he really does start to bring other players into the contest. Again, when the Giants are struggling for opportunities, struggling to get it inside 50, those are the sort of free kicks that you just can't afford to give away, and a bloke like Darren Ewing is going to hurt you straight out bang in front.
Now, percentage is already starting to play a part already. 77 playing 19 as we, deep into red time at the moment. About 25 minutes gone so far. So the umpire bounces the ball. We'll tell you more about that percentage a little bit later on. Interesting how they're not calling those sort of bounces back at the moment. Favouring the Giants. Great smother there by the weapon. He's up and running. In fact, it's Vassell. He pops it in the area, and a fine mark nearly taken there by the likes of Ewing and also Jed Anderson. But they stacks on the mill, and, that was brilliant stuff there by Vassell. We've really missed his intensity around the stoppages, and a handy inclusion tonight as the ball bounced on the sandy surface as such, and a free kick going the way.
Just another one.
Of the NT Thunder.
Yep.
And we're just trying to figure out who's actually got the kick. It's Willie. Oh, no, he's swapping around. Well, there's the man that did all the hard work with the smother and the one percenter before, Brad Vassell. He's done some great stuff so far this year. Had some niggling injuries in the middle of the year, but he's just getting his body right at the right time of the year, especially with finals around the corner, as he slots that one straight through the middle. And, well, it'd be safe to say this is turning into a whitewash at the moment. 13-5-83 to 3-1-19. 26 minutes gone, deep into red time. A lot of goals kicked this quarter as well, so you would think it would approach the 30-minute mark anyway. And, UWS, they're treading water at the moment.
Yeah, they certainly are. Just to give you an idea of how prolific Thunder have been, 10 goals to 1 in this third quarter. So
wow.
26 and a half minutes in, that's a pretty good average. So the margin now is 64 points in favour of Thunder. Hope you're enjoying our company here on Tats Thunder Vision, the home of Territory Football, territoryfc.com.au, as the Rucks go at it. And poor old Phillips, he's up against it again. Nice kick away there in the end was Aylett driving up towards centre-half forward.
Played
by the big fella in Downey. Gets the handball over the top to Asan. Asan from about 25 metres out goes bang, and a very, very quick answering goal. Well done indeed by the Giants. Getting the hands on the ball at the clearances is king. And, that was a bit of a bolt out of the blue. There, they've got themselves a goal back.
But that's how they got their goals, haven't it?
Yeah.
It's been out of the clearances, it's been in the right spots at the right time, and running as well.
Yeah.
And you're seeing it from a lot of their top-up players as well, which is great to see. They've just got to get that strength out there, and Phillips won the tap out.
Yep.
Tyrrell hit the ground, he kept his feet, ball kept rolling on forward. Brilliant stuff there by UWS. Hey, look, there's plenty of talent in this side. They're kicking straight 4-1, so when they are getting their opportunities inside that forward 50, they're making the most of it. Let's see what KT does this time in response to what just happened. So, ball, beautiful bounce that time. Tyrrell taps it down, looking for Dignan, maybe dealt with severely.
Yep.
Play on, says the umpire, no, free kick. So there will be a free kick going the way of Diggin. Got a couple of free kicks so far tonight. Out towards the jet in Heenan. Oh, spent it before he had it. And I'd hate to see what he was like with pocket money when he was a kid. Get it off there to Williams Jr. Going backwards to go forwards. Just trying to create some space at the moment. Heenan spots up Verncombe. So Verncombe in the centre of the ground. Looking for some prospects along the outer side. Doesn't hit the ground, it does so this time. Vassal under a little bit of pressure. Rosier's in the area as well. UWS surrounded by black shirts. Brilliant stuff there by Dignan. It's a worm-burning kick, but it's in the area of Lachlan Argus. He lost what he could have had. Great work there by Ben Rioli. Does he get the patience that he needs? Oh. He hits the woodwork. Oh. Well, it looked exciting, and it was exciting as well for me as well, calling this one in the dark at the moment. It's hard to see some of the players out there, but we're loving the action here at TIO Stadium as the ball's about to get, kicked in yet again, deep into red time, 28 minutes gone. All players just spilling the pack there that time. Durkay lost the handle on it. Wasley Black loses it as well. Vassal spins and turns. Puts it on his left. Has to be a good-looking kick. Off the hands and through for a behind. Nearly something special from the Vassman.
Yes, good kick there. Good centering kick. Could have quite easily blazed away and gone for glory. But the ball now coming out. Good spot-up kick in the end. And he finds Jack Homsch. He's been very prolific tonight, the Sturt boy, the double blue. Oh, coming in over the top there. Well, to try and spoil it away was Rosier, but getting it back was Wilson. He's got, looks like it's Aylett over the top.
Oh, brilliant.
And again, they've turned it over to the Thunder here. Rosier goes to Chris Dunn. Jeez, Mr. Spreadable is having the lion's share of it so far this evening.
Patrick Heen and Matty Rosier, this is your goal if Mr. Spreadable pops it through and Chris Dunn. Great work. Heenan's coming off for a rest. He's been really good on the wings tonight.
As the Stop Go Girls do their best work again, the weapon is on. Kieran Smith is on. Matty Argus is on. Heenan, Perry, Tyrrell, and also Ash Duncan are off as Chris Dunn goes bang and misses. He's put it through.
First miss.
Just sliding through for one behind. So Thunder 13-8-86. UWS 4-1-25. We've played just over 30 minutes in this second term.
This is what happens when you miss the spreadable. You sometimes go with the crunchy and they get left on your boot. But anyway, we'll stop with the dad jokes. As the ball goes high and up in the air, and UWS under a bit of pressure, but a fine mark taken nonetheless. Great work there by the number 44 in Thomas Downey. Mark when he was under a hell of a lot of pressure. So he goes along the outer side, looking for another top mark. Ooh. Instead, there's plenty of Thunder shirts around it. Smith trying to get it up. That was Green, though. He got it off to Durkay. Away go UWS. They run the full measure there. Maybe a little bit too far. Looking for that. And, geez, that's the third poster for the night. Would not be too happy with that one. And that was Nathan Wilson who had a ping for it. So the Thunder out of the back line. All smothered off the boot. Done. Mr. Spreadable. This is what I say. Pops up in the right places at the right time. Argus had to wait for that one. And a fine mark taken that time there by Kennedy. So Kennedy, hand passes off, starting to link up now, UWS, they're lining up for it, in fact. It's like a queue at a deli line. So Durkay, what can he do? Goes off the side of the boot, it's probably not going to help, but Hassan plays on quickly, spinning it around the corner, looks for Phillips, and the big man marks. So that's a great build-up there by UWS, everyone in the right spots at the right time, and the build-up was good as well. They looked after the ball, Hassan had to work really hard for it, did come off hands, but Phillips, the long arms of the law. The big redhead. Obviously a fiery personality after the combatants have been going at it with himself and Kenrick Tyrrell in the ruck work tonight. He's been rucking really well too. So the number 27, point blank in front. Does not make absolute blemish on that. It was brilliant as it went all the way through the middle. Right on the siren. And UWS get their fifth for the night. It's 5-2-32 to 13-8-86. Geez, look, the Thunder, they kicked, 10 goals that quarter. Probably had a chance to kick a couple more there, Josh. But UWS, they won't go away. They're still lingering, obviously, and their confidence isn't shattered. This is the bonus about being a youthful side. They're still up and about.
Yeah, it certainly is.